Chicago's COVID-19 vaccine trial is officially underway.
First participants rolling up their sleeves earlier today. WGN's Dana Baer has more.
We first heard about the Chicago arm of biotech company Moderna's COVID-19 vaccine trial in June. That's when researchers at the University of Illinois at Chicago announced the phase 3 study designed to see how effective it is. Today, we met the very first volunteers.
I feel honored to be able to do it and to maybe help people understand the importance of doing it.
One down, 999 more participants to go. Bonnie Blue is the first. She arrived at UIC at 8:30 a.m., ready to take part in the historic trial. The process started with a vital sign check and a blood draw. The 68-year-old great-grandmother said she signed up to save others of her generation.
An entire generation of grandparents that will could be lost. And with that loss of grandparents, you're losing family history, you're losing family culture, you're losing all of that wisdom and that grandparent love, okay? And it's like, well, wait a minute, that is cheating those children.
Down the hall, participant number 2, 55-year-old Eduardo Rolox.
One thing that's not known is how the vaccine affects different populations.
He too felt compelled to take part in the city's first COVID-19 vaccine trial. UIC head of infectious diseases, Dr. Richard Novak, is heading up the effort to enroll 1,000 participants in the double-blinded placebo-controlled trial, then follow them for 2 years, though he says results could be available sooner.
The disease is very active in the community, and there'll be more cases, and the study will end sooner. So it's largely dependent on how active the disease is in the study population.
Participants will be randomly assigned to one of 2 groups, a study group, which will receive the vaccine, and a control group, which will get a placebo. A total of 30,000 people will be enrolled across the country in what's being called Operation Warp Speed. Earlier studies of the Moderna product showed it's safe.
The majority of people don't get any symptoms. They don't have any side effects. So it appears that it's safe.
The experimental vaccine triggers the body to produce decoy spikes, much like those on the surface of SARS-CoV-2. That kicks the immune system into gear. So when it sees the actual virus, it produces powerful antibodies, preventing the virus spikes from puncturing and infecting cells.
Those projections or spikes are what the virus uses to attach to our cells in order to get inside and cause infection. So it's sort of like a lock and key phenomenon. So the spike is the key that unlocks a cell to get inside. The vaccine makes your cells produce the spike protein, and then your immune system recognizes that it's a foreign substance, makes an immune response to it.
The immune response is similar to the response that occurs when someone is naturally infected. And although that infection was believed to protect from future illness, a new study in the journal Clinical Infectious Diseases reveals a previously infected patient came down with a variant of the coronavirus which causes COVID-19 months after the initial illness. Doctors say they're not deterred and believe the vaccine will work better.
The immune response from the vaccine is much more potent and effective than the natural immunity that occurs from an infection, a real infection with coronavirus. So we are very hopeful that the vaccine will be more effective than natural immunity to the virus.
Among those Dr. Novak hopes to attract in this test group, individuals 65 and older and those with underlying health conditions like diabetes and heart disease, particularly within Black and brown communities.
Those groups happen to be the most impacted by the coronavirus pandemic, and therefore it's very important that they participate in this vaccine trial because we want to know if the vaccine will work in African Americans and Latinos. The only way we'll know that is if they also participate in the trial.
We are all, for myself, I am just one thin thread in the tapestry of humanity, but we all have a part to play in this. I mean, everybody doesn't have to stick their arm out for an injection, but there are so many things that people can do. But right now, we all have to be responsible and do what needs to be done so that we can all survive.
There are multiple vaccine candidates scheduled to move to phase 3 testing this summer, with at least two other products to be tested right here in Chicago. UIC has set up a phone line for those interested in participating. They've already received 8,000 inquiries. We have more details on our website. Back to you.